Tourette's is a tic disorder which affects nearly 4% of children. These tics are characterized by sudden and rapid movements or vocalizations which are outside of the individual's control. Why does this happen, and how does this affect patients? To answer these questions, we'll need to take a deeper look at this condition. Tourette's syndrome is classified as a motor tic disorder under the neurodevelopmental disorders category in the 5th edition of the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual, or the DSM-5, which is used to characterize and diagnose mental disorders. According to the DSM-5, Tourette's is diagnosed if an individual has repeated tics that start before they turned 18, and if there were no other possible causes for these tics, such as substance use or another medical condition. Tourette's has three categories: pure Tourette syndrome, which includes just motor and vocal tics; full-blown Tourette syndrome, which includes involuntary expressions of socially unacceptable words or actions; and Tourette syndrome plus, where the patient will also have a diagnosis of either ADHD, OCD, and depression, among other mental health conditions. These extra conditions can often be more distressing than the tics themselves. Tourette's will present differently in different patients. However, there is one symptom that ties all people with Tourette's together, that is tics. Tics are sudden, repetitive movements or vocalizations and are classified as a hyperkinetic movement disorder, meaning that someone with Tourette's will experience excessive movements. Tics can involve almost every muscle group, and some tics will occur more than others. Simple motor tics are caused by brief activations of one muscle or muscle group, like blinking or nose twitching and shoulder shrugging. On the other hand, complex motor tics are caused by the activation of more than one muscle group and result in movements like jumping or clapping or rubbing. The same applies for vocal tics. Simple vocal tics include throat clearing, sniffing, and coughing. Complex vocal tics involve words, whole sentences, and also repetitions of another person's vocalizations. Some well-known tics, like involuntary swearing and obscene gestures, are actually forms of complex tics. These affect less than 30% of people with Tourette's. Tics generally lessen during times of relaxation, but become more prominent when an individual feels excited, anxious, or exhausted. Depending on tic severity, an individual may or may not be affected in daily life by them. Although tics aren't inherently life-threatening, those that do experience them often face discrimination and ostracization in society because of them. Why do tics occur? And why are they so hard to control? Although there's still more research being done on the exact causes, there's a lot of evidence to suggest that it has something to do with the basal ganglia, a part of the brain that's involved in controlling movement. In a healthy basal ganglia, you're able to control your movements through a combination of excitatory and inhibitory signals. The other parts of your brain basically send instructions with excitation or inhibition to the basal ganglia. The basal ganglia integrates them and sends these signals to your muscles to tell them how to move. With the proper balance of excitatory and inhibitory signals in the basal ganglia, your muscles will move exactly the way you intend them to. With tics, however, there seems to be a lot more excitatory signals than inhibitory ones. This can lead to jerky and unexpected movements or vocalizations. So what can someone with Tourette's do? Is there a cure or a way to stop these tics from happening? The short answer is no, not really. For those who live with Tourette's, this can be really hard to hear. However, there are treatments to manage these symptoms. Someone with Tourette's can undergo habit reversal training, which is a behavioral therapy designed to help a person become aware of their tics and then replace a disruptive tic with a less disruptive action. For example, if a person has a tic that involves rubbing their head, they're trained to recognize this as a tic so they can replace it with a competing action, like placing the hands on the knees. This can be paired with relaxation techniques to help out even more. Behavioral therapies are recommended for early or mild cases of Tourette's. In cases where this isn't an option, the patient can also take some medications to help their specific symptoms. As everyone experiences Tourette's differently, these treatments must be tailored to the individual, so it's best to consult with a qualified professional for treatment options. Although Tourette's and tics can be unpleasant, there are resources available to help out. For anyone with Tourette's, you may find help in other support groups like Camp Stick Together, run by Tourette's Canada. While we can't make tics go away, over time, those with Tourette's will learn to live with them. For everybody else, if you want to learn more about Tourette's and tics, we'll link some educational sources in the description. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and follow us on our Twitter and SoundCloud for more content.